Hi, it's Greg again from HOK. Center block is such a complex project, it's important that we give the stakeholders the ability to monitor and view the work as it proceeds. Mark Cici, my colleague, is going to walk you through that process now.
Hi, I'm Mark Cici. I am a principal and the director of design technology at HOK. We currently have about 75 terabytes of reality capture data. That accounts for terrestrial laser scanning, hand scanning, orthographic imagery, and photogrammetry. The reality capture data that we currently have represents the first 3 years of the project's existence. We still have around 7 years to go, which means that 75 terabytes will balloon by the time we get to the end till around 350 to 400 terabytes of data. We've developed an application leveraging Unreal Engine that allows us to concatenate all of the aspects of the reality capture we've done to date. This streams the data in from a variety of sources, including our local data center and Cintoo in the cloud. We'll ultimately deliver the application via pixel streaming on cloud. The primary purpose of the pixel streaming application is meant to give context to the entire trajectory of the project. So it allows you to, in effect, trace the entire state of every space in the building throughout its history. That means we can go back to the beginning, before construction, when the building hadn't had any demolition acted upon it. And it means that we can always go back to the very end where we've reinstated the finished materials. We can also investigate anything in between. We can look behind mechanical ductwork. We can see at what state drywall was removed and replaced, and if there's any differential between what the design documents say in regards to where a conduit may be placed or where it actually is in reality. And we can actually track that delta and see over the course of the history of that space where the services are and what the finishes ultimately transition to. Leveraging Unreal Engine and pixel streaming in this way allows us to create a comprehensive and robust versioning system of the geometry and the point cloud scan data throughout the project's entire history. We've been investigating the use of 3D Repo in parallel to create a supplemental versioning system that allows us to trace our BIM-related data and the Revit model specifically throughout its existence so that we can compare that information when upgrades are performed or when major model changes are executed. In addition to this, we've been leveraging the new plugin that's been developed by 3D Repo to be able to stream that content and those differential checks into Unreal Engine. Now I'll hand it over to Joseph to speak a little bit more about that process and what they're doing with Unreal Engine.
Hi, I'm Dr. Joseph Dabosch, the founder and CEO of 3D Repo. With HOK, we've been working on countless innovations over the years, and this project is no exception. We've been instrumental in cloud-based data validation and large-scale geometry processing that would not have been possible otherwise. Using 3D Repo, HOK were able to push their complicated 3D models straight from the authoring tools to the cloud for version control and federation purposes. Since all of the data is available through the APIs, there is no need to recompile and reissue the game anymore because all of the data is instantly available using Unreal Engine in the editor as well as during runtime. This way, client-facing visualizations can be developed and kept in step with the engineering process without any further delay. HOK were also able to retrieve 3D locations, metadata, and other engineering information directly from the cloud without the need to build their own infrastructure. 3D Repo has been built directly on top of the existing AEC workflows, so Unreal experience can be simply enabled by installing our own plugin. For us, UE5 delivered significant performance improvements as well as decoupling of the rendering pipeline from the underlying data structures so that we were able to populate them dynamically on the fly. UE5 was not just about visual fidelity, but more importantly about processing capability and prowess. We are very much looking forward to continued partnership with both HOK and Epic Games.